Today on Animal Fact Files, we're discussing giant siphonophores. This episode was a request from a member of our Patreon community. Giant siphonophores have earned their common name. These organisms are giants, in terms of length anyway. Stretched out, a giant siphonophore can reach over 130 feet in length, and some are believed to grow even longer. There are, however, two issues with actually seeing a fully intact, living giant siphonophore. One, they live in the ocean where light rarely, if ever, reaches. Giant siphonophores have been found in the Atlantic, Pacific, Indian, and Antarctic seas, but they haven't been spotted in the Mediterranean or the Arctic Ocean. They're typically described as a subtropical species, but considering they live upwards of 3,300 feet below the ocean surface, they can handle some pretty cold temperatures. For reference, it's about 40 degrees Fahrenheit at that depth. Not a bath I would want to take. Of course, I wouldn't be able to anyway, because the pressure would crush me. But the gelatinous giant siphonophore can handle it. The other reason these animals are difficult to see complete in their natural environment is, two, they break apart really easily. Like other siphonophores, these invertebrates are colony organisms, which means they are made up of many individual parts working together to form an entire colony. Each part plays a role, such as food collection, reproduction, and defense, and together they are able to survive. It's sort of like a tree and its leaves. The roots gather nutrients, the leaves gather sunlight and process it into food. The trunk transports everything and keeps it standing tall. All the parts work in unison to form a whole. For the giant siphonophore, there are two large, bell-shaped pieces that are used for movement. These expand and contract to create jet propulsion in the water. Then there are smaller pieces making up the length of the body. These may have dangling tentacles, which form an underwater stinging curtain that catches just about anything in its path. Giant siphonophores eat planktonic organisms, crustaceans, and possibly small fish that become entangled in the invertebrate's curtain of tentacles. Prey are attracted to the siphonophore because it gives off a blue glow of bioluminescence. Once caught, the food is processed by other members of the colony and is transported throughout the whole body along the trunk. Around, a giant siphonophore's trunk is only about the width of a broom handle. So while they can grow longer than a blue whale, they're still nowhere near as big. Currently, there are no known predators of giant siphonophores, but there's still a lot about these elusive creatures to learn. For more facts on giant siphonophores, check out the links below. Give a thumbs up if you learned something new today. Thank you to our patrons, SpikeSpiegel93, Dad, and everyone else for their support of this channel. And thank you for watching Animal Fact Files.